Hello friends, my name is Sandeep Patil and I welcome you to this very unique and very innovative method of developing your English communication where I do not teach any grammar but I use natural techniques which will help you to be fluent and confident speaker. This is video number 11. If you haven't seen my previous videos, please go and watch those videos. Only then you will understand what's happening here. Directly don't watch these videos. And I also promise you that if you watch all the videos carefully, I mean all the 1 to 11 videos carefully, I'm sure it will help you to understand exactly what to do and which direction to go. Many people are confused about how to improve their communication. They're watching some video number 1 or video number 10, no use. See here what happens is, clarity is more important. Once you get the clarity, once you get the right direction, how to do it, what is the right method, the plan, the blueprint, you can achieve your goal of being fluent. So in this video, I'm going to talk about the lifestyle change which you have to do, that is reading, how to make this lifestyle change, what is the psychology behind these changes, how to do these changes, and how to make sure that this change lasts permanently, because consistency, long-term commitment is the key for developing your fluency and your confidence. Stay tuned with me. Watch my video till end and you will understand all the details properly. Come on, have some patience. Well, friends, see here, the fact is, as I have told before in my video number 10 and previous videos, language has to be acquired. You cannot by heart a language. You can by heart a subject. You can by heart maths formally, physics formally. You cannot by heart a language. It has to be acquired. Acquiring a language means making some permanent changes in your brain structure, in your part of the brain called Broca's area and Wernicke's area. There, these changes must be done. But to make these changes, you have to make changes in your lifestyle. Lifestyle. Lifestyle means what? How you spend your day, how you live your day, what are your different activities, what are your habits. This is called as your lifestyle change and this must be permanent and not temporary. Let us take an example. Many people adopt a new lifestyle change. Every day I see many people outside here where I'm shooting, they are on cycle. Okay, but how many days they are cycling? How many days they are jogging? When I see them, after 1 month, no one comes. All new people are there. The routine is not there, they don't follow the routine, and after 1 month or maximum 2 months, everything is stopped and they sold, sell the cycle and the jogging is stopped, they are back to normal. Why they do it? Because once you start jogging, for example, 1 month no change, 2 months no change, 6 months also no change, even 1 year also you will see no change. Now who is going to continue if you don't see any change after 1 year? But actually the change is happening. The change is very slow and very subtle. There is an internal change. We can say change is underneath. Change is underground, which is not visible, but it is happening. But we want instant changes. And most of the people give up jogging. Now, those who are very fit, you can ask them since how many years they are jogging. I'm using the word years. And they will tell you that they are jogging or cycling since many years. I told you on my channel, I tell the fact. It's very authentic whatever I speak. I am not interested in giving you a quick fix solution and impress you. I want to tell you the fact. Even if you don't like, I want to tell you this. Now let us apply this for English. I want to tell you that you have to make a change in your reading habits. But again, it's a lifestyle change. You have to, first of all, according to the research, 98% people do not read any book in their entire life after completing their formal academics. Never they read any book. This is the first problem. Second problem is we don't read books in English. That is the second problem. And third problem is we cannot read continuously for many months and years. This is another problem. How to deal with this? Now listen carefully, I will explain you. See here, I have seen people, they come and tell me that, sir, I want to be fluent and I want to read for that. I will read, sir. You tell me whatever you want, I will do it. But their focus is on English and they are focusing on result and not the process. we have to change this and change our mindset, our psychology, and adapt process-oriented approach than result-oriented approach. Listen carefully what I'm saying. Process-oriented means what? You have to focus on the process and not the result. When you achieve any result, it has to go through a process. In short, it has to travel a road. You have to focus on the road. You have to focus on the journey and not the destination. Why this is? Because results are not in our control. Results will take some time, may take more time also, maybe 1 year, 2 year, 4 year, 5 year. English language development is the only course which needs many months and years to develop. But many YouTubers, many teachers are afraid to tell you that because they feel that you will not like it. And therefore, they are claiming that you can be fluent in 21 days and 2 months and 6 months, which is not the fact. In my online training, I never tell all these negative things, all these, dubious claims. I don't do all these dubious claims. I tell the fact. I tell the reality. And this is the reason why today all my online, offline students are getting results. I program their mind for the long-term commitment. That is what I do. I don't teach English. I change the mindset, which helps them to develop the English. In short, I don't give them a fish. I teach them fishing, because if you give someone a fish, you can feed him for 1 day. But if you teach the person fishing, he can feed himself for an entire life. Focus on the process, not on the results. Results are not in your control. It will take time. Focus on the process. What I mean to say is focus on reading. Focus on gaining the knowledge. Focus on acquiring the content of that book. And forget English. Forget fluency. When you forget fluency, forget result, and focus on the process, English will follow you. It's like a puppy, a small puppy, chasing its mother. Like same way, English will follow you. You just keep on focusing on the process. One more thing. Don't make a sudden change in your reading. Now, after watching my video, don't go and open a book which you did for 2 and 3 hours. No use. Make a small change. Read, start from 10 minutes a day and gradually increase that to half an hour and 1 hour. Another thing, do not go and get a big, thick book. No use. For example, this kind of books. Don't read this kind of books. No use. Select an easy book. Select a book which you like, which is interesting for you, and then go for that book. This is the second thing. Another thing, it may happen that you may stop reading or you may skip reading, but do not skip reading for more than 2 days. If you skip more than 2 days, third and fourth day will be very difficult to again go back and read and continue the habit. And most probably you will quit it. So these are some of the important points which I wanted to tell you. Again, I repeat, focus on process, not on the results. All of you getting my point? Focus on process, not on the results. Second point, equally important, make small changes. Read 30, 20, 10 minutes, then gradually increase it to 1 hour and 2 hour. Next point, start with easy books, which are easy to understand. Don't directly go and read some philosophy or difficult books. Don't do that. And last thing is, don't skip more than 2 or 3 days. If you skip, you will not be able to regain that momentum and continue with this. And last tip again I'll give you, if you still skip, don't feel guilty about it. Just, it's okay if you skip, if you miss. Tell yourself you are a human, you are fallible human, and again go and start reading. Guys, these are some of the important tips which I want to give you if you want to adapt this lifestyle change, that is reading change. This will help you a lot. Guys, come on, start reading. And from my side, happy reading. Take care, friends. And goodbye, all of you. See you.